our management accountability series on manufacturing company costs. So we're going to take up where we left off in part four with our three inventory accounts for a manufacturing company and how the costs flow through those T accounts. So just a quick overview. Remember, when we used materials, the direct materials went into work in process. Along with direct labor and overhead, those three costs made up product costs. Once a product was completed, it moved out of work in process into finished goods as our cost of goods manufactured. And it remained in finished goods until the product was sold and we expensed it as cost of goods sold. So just a little bit more terminology here. Your beginning materials plus purchases is called your cost of materials available for use. Your beginning work in process plus your product costs, materials, labor, and overhead, is called your costs to account for. Your beginning finished goods plus your cost of goods manufactured is called your cost of goods available for sale. And again, your direct materials plus your direct labor plus your overhead make up what is called product cost. Remember, you can also hear that called inventoriable cost or manufacturing costs. Another term I'd like for you to be familiar with is prime costs. Prime costs are made up of your direct materials plus your direct labor. These are called prime cost because they're direct cost. They are directly associated with the product, and they are the prime cost of that product. Conversion costs are your direct labor plus your overhead. They're called conversion costs because it takes direct labor and overhead to convert direct materials into a finished good. Let's look at an example here of computing materials used. So you're a new accounting intern at the warehouse. Your boss gives you the following information and asks you to compute direct materials used. So we're given purchases of direct materials, we're given freight in, we're given property taxes, ending and beginning materials. So for me, the easiest way to compute our materials used is to draw that materials T account. So we'll start with the T account. And remember, this is an inventory account, so it's an asset. So any beginning and ending inventories will appear on the debit side. So we're just going to fill in the information that we know. We know we start with beginning materials. We know that purchases make materials go up. And we've also learned that freight in is not an expense, but it's considered part of the cost of our inventory, in this case, our materials. And also we have our ending materials. When materials move out of our materials inventory account into work in process, that's called materials used. And that is what we're looking to calculate here. So let's just fill in the information that we know. We know beginning inventory is $4,200. We know our purchases of materials was $6,700. And we know our freight in is $100. And our ending inventory is $1,600. So if we take all of our debits, add them up, and then subtract our ending, we will get materials used to be $9,400. Overhead, there are three types of costs that are included as part of overhead. Indirect materials, indirect labor, and other overhead. So for example, let's say we're producing wooden chairs. The wood to produce the chair would be a major part of the cost of the product. That would be considered a direct material. An indirect material might be glue, a little bit of glue that's used on the chair to glue things together or to make things more stable. That would be considered an indirect material. Labor. Well, the people that put the chair together, actually hands-on putting the chair together, would be called direct labor. An example of indirect labor may be the custodian in the plant. The word plant is your key word there. And other overhead would be things like utilities for the plant or depreciation on plant equipment. So let's look at an example, and we're going to add up here our total overhead cost from these selected accounts given. So Moondust Manufacturers Sunglasses. Suppose the company's August records include the following items. Calculate Moondust's total manufacturing overhead cost in August. So we're looking for overhead here. So let's start with glue for the frames. Well, let's just quickly scan the dollar amounts of all these items here. So they're pretty small, except for the company president's salary and lenses. Well, we know the company president's salary is not part of the product, but lenses, that is actually part of the sunglasses. And look how much it is. So we can tell by looking at the amount and thinking about lenses and knowing it's part of the product that that is actually a direct material. It's a prime cost of that product. So let's go back to glue for the frames. Now comparing the glue with the lenses, $400 to $48,000, we can assume that glue is an indirect cost, an indirect material. It's going to be part of the product, but it's not really cost advantageous for us to trace that cost back to the product. So we just call it an indirect material, and it's included as part of overhead. How about depreciation expense on company cars used by the sales force? Well, the word sales, that clues us in that this is a selling expense. So it's not a product cost, it's an operating cost. How about plant depreciation expense? There's that key word that I told you about, plant. Plant depreciation. Anytime you see the word plant or factory or manufacturing, that's a pretty good clue that that is going to be overhead. So in this case, plant depreciation would be that third category of overhead called other overhead. So the key word plant there, so this is overhead. Interest expense. Interest expense is an operating expense. Actually, it's an other expense underneath operating. So it is not a product cost. Company president's salary. Well, the company president is not working in the plant. He's working in the administrative building. He's an admin person. So that is an administrative expense, another operating expense. How about the plant foreman's salary? Again, that key word, plant. So that is overhead. Plant janitor's wages. Again, that key word, plant. That is overhead. It's indirect labor. Oil for the manufacturing equipment. There's the key word, manufacturing. That is other overhead, so that is included as part of overhead. And we distinguished earlier that lenses is a direct material. It is not part of overhead. It's a product cost, but it's not part of overhead. So if we add up all the ones indicated here, you will find that your overhead cost equal $11,150.